Good day to you all. I am C.S. Srinivas Rao, Associate Professor, Department of Computer Science, SVKP, and Dr. K.S. Raja Arts and Science College, Penguanda. I welcome you all for the class of Graph Theory in Discrete Mathematical Structures. Graphs. A graph G consists of two things. One is the set of vertices and set of edges. So, capital V is equal to V of G, whose elements are called vertices, are the points, are the nodes of graph G. Set capital E is equal to E of G. So this is unordered pair of distinct vertices called edges of G. Now that is, a graph is denoted by G of V comma E. This is the where V is the vertices, E is the edges. The graph G of VE, where V consists of vertices A, B, C, D and E consists of edges. E1 is AB, this is the E1, and E2 is BC, E3 is CD, and E4 is AC, and E5 is BD, right? DB or BD. So this is the graph. This is the one graph, set of vertices AB, CD are the vertices, and E1, E2, E3, E4, E5 are the edges. Now the next one is multigraph. Multigraph. The edges E4 and E5 are called multi-edges. So here the E4 and E5, these are the multiple edges. These are the multiple edges between the two vertices, the same vertices, that is called B and C. Between B and C, there are two vertices. One is E4 and second one is E5. And similarly, you take the D, vertex D, it has the one edge. This is called a loop. E6 is the edge that is between the same vertex D. Now here the edges E4 and E5 are called multiple edges since they connect the same endpoints, and the edge E6 is called a loop. This is a loop since its endpoints are the same vertex, single vertex. Such diagram is called multigraph. This is called multigraph. Simple graph is a graph without multiple edges and loops, without any multiple edges and a loop. That graph is called simple graph. Now one more terminology is degree of vertex. Degree of a vertex. For each and every vertex, you calculate the degree. What is the degree of vertex? Degree of vertex for the V in a graph G written as DEZ of V. DEZ of V is the degree of vertex. This is equal to number of edges in G which contain the V, vertex V, which are incident on V. Incident on V. For example, if you take degree of A, suppose this is the A, degree of A is 2, 1 and 2. These two edges are incident on the vertex A, and degree of B. So the degree of B is this one, 1, 2, 3. So the vertex E, vertex B, the edges are E2, E5, E1. These three are incident on B. Similarly, you calculate the degree of C. This is the degree of C, and the degree of D is 2. This is the way to calculate the degree of each and every vertex. A vertex of degree 0 is called an isolated vertex. There is no edge for it. So, vertex of degree 0. Degree 0 is called isolated vertex. Now, the next terminology is finite graphs and a trivial graph. A finite graph. A multigraph is said to be finite if it has finite number of vertices and a finite number of edges. The finite number of vertices and finite number of edges, then that multigraph is called finite. Finite multigraph. And a trivial graph, the finite graph with one vertex and no edges, single point is called trivial graph. Subgraph is nothing but some part of the partition of the multigraph, or the some part of the multigraph. Consider a graph G, it consists the capital V and capital E, these are the number of vertices and number of edges. A graph H is the subgraph, it has V power R and E power R is called a subgraph of G. H is the subgraph of G. If the vertices of vertices and edges of H are contained in the vertices and edges of G, that is, VR is the subset of V and ER is the subset of E. So then that particular graph H is the subgraph of G. Isomorphic graph. So graphs G and the V comma E and another graph is V star E star are said to be isomorphic if there exists one-to-one correspondence. There is a function f. V2, V star, such that UV is an edge of G if and only if F of U and F of V is an edge in G star. This is the way to find out the isomorphic graphs. So just isomorphic graphs, you take the two graphs, whether those two are isomorphic or not, you verify it. Now see this isomorphic graphs. We note that A and R, see this, A and R, these two are isomorphic. The symbolically these two are different, but the same properties, that's why these two are the isomorphic. How you specify these two are isomorphic? So first of all, you consider the things. Number of vertices must be equal. Now here the for A, number of vertices are 5. Here is also 5. Number of edges are equal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 edges. For R also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 edges. So 5 vertices and 5 edges. And similarly, you take the degrees of each and every vertex. So the degree, 1 degree vertices are 2. Here is also 2, 1 degree vertices, this and this. 2 degree vertices, here the 2 degree vertex is 1, here is 2 degree vertex is 1. 3 degree vertices are 3, 1, 2, 3, here 1, 2, 3. 3 degree vertices are 2, here these two are the 3 degree vertices. Now here is also, there are 3 2 degree vertices. So that's why A and R both are the isomorphic graphs. So similarly, one more condition is there. Not only these conditions, one is the condition, one is the number of vertices must be equal, second condition is the number of edges must be equal, and third one is the degrees of the corresponding vertices must be equal. The corresponding vertices must be equal. These are the three conditions. Now one more thing is, you have to verify the degrees of adjacent vertices also must be the same. Sometimes, so here the degree is 2. The equal, the degree single, 1 degree, 2 vertices, 2 degree, 1 vertex, 3 degree, 2 vertices. So here is also same, but the order is different. In that case, you have to verify the adjacent vertices, degree must be the equal. That is the additional condition. So anyhow, first you verify the number of vertices must be equal, and the second condition is number of edges must be equal, and third condition is degree of each and every vertex must be equal. Similarly, you verify F and T. See this. Number of vertices 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5. F and T. These two are the isomorphic. And single degree vertices are 3. 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. And 2 degree vertices 1. Here is 2 degree vertex is 1. And 3 degree vertex is 1. Here is 3 degree vertex is 1. And the final condition, I am saying the one more thing is, for this 1 degree vertex, for 1 degree vertex, there is a 1 adjacent vertex, it has the 2 degree. Similarly, you can find 1 degree vertex, it has the 2 degree vertex. This is the adjacent verification. So for 1 degree vertex, the adjacent is, adjacent degree of adjacent vertex degree is 2. That means this one is mapped with this one. And 2 degree vertex, this is the 2 degree vertex. For 2 degree vertex, the adjacent is 3 degree. So the 3 degree vertex, the adjacent is 2 degree. So see this, 2 degree, right? So this is equivalent to this one. And similarly, 1 degree vertex is adjacent to 3 degree. 1 degree vertex is adjacent to this one. This 1 degree vertex is adjacent to this one. This 1 degree. So these two are similar. These two are similar. 3 degree, these two are similar. This one is similar with this one. This one is similar with this one. Like that, you compare the total number of vertices, total number of edges, the degrees of each and every vertex, and adjacent vertices degrees must be the same, right? So these are the four conditions we need to verify whether those two graphs are isomorphic or not. Similarly, you can verify K and X, these two are the isomorphic. Similarly, M, S, V and Z, M, S, V and Z are also isomorphic, right? Homeomorphic is any graph G. We can obtain a new graph by dividing an edge of G with additional vertices. So this is the one graph. This is the one main graph. So homeographic, two graphs G and G star are said to be homeographic if they can be obtained from the same graph is the isomorphic graphs by this method. The graphs A and B, these two are not isomorphic, but these two are the homeomorphic because these two are obtained from this one. So these two graphs are obtained from this one. That means by adding these two vertices here, you put the vertices here, then you can obtain this graph from this one, and similarly you can obtain this graph from this one. Put this vertex and this vertex here and here. So this graph is also obtained from this one, this graph is also obtained from this one. Hence these two graphs are obtained from this one. These two are the homeographic, but these two are not isomorphic because see that our number of vertices are equal. Here see 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here is also 4 plus 3, 7, where 1 degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 degree, 4, 1 degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 vertices. 2 degree, 1, here is 2, 2 degree, see this, 1, 2, and 4 degree, this is 4 degree, even though these two are not isomorphic. Why? Because so for the 2 degree, this 2 degree, what is the adjacent vertex? 4 degree vertex. So for this 2 degree, there is a 4 degree vertex. For this 2 degree, this is the 4 degree vertex. For this 2 degree, 4 degree vertex is not found. So this is the adjacent vertex for this one is 1 degree and 2 degree. This is 1 degree and 4 degree. So these two are not equal. These two are not mapping. So hence these two are not isomorphic. These two graphs are not isomorphic. But these two are homeomorphic because these two are obtained from the original this one. Path and connectivity. A path in a multigraph G consists of an alternate sequence of vertices and edges. See this V0 to Vn. So V0 E1 and you can visit the V1, and from there to you go through E2 and you can visit the V2. Like that there is a sequence of vertices. There are n number of n plus 1 vertices and there are n number of edges, n plus 1 vertices and n edges. So there are n number of vertices, n minus 1 of edges. So where each edge ei contains the vertices vi minus 1 and vi, there are two vertices are combined with the one edge. The number n of edges is called length of the path. Here there are n number of edges, so the length of this path is n number of edges, the length is n. We denote a path by a sequence of vertices. So V0, V1, V2 up to Vn, the path is said to be closed. If it is the path is closed, then V0 is equal to Vn. V0 is equal to Vn, then that path is closed. A simple path is a path in which all vertices are distinct. All vertices are distinct. A path in which all edges are distinct, that is called trial. All edges are distinct, that is called trial. All vertices are distinct, that path is called simple path. Trial is a path, edges are distinct, and all vertices are distinct, that path is called simple path. A cycle is closed, is a closed path of length 3 or more. So length 3 or more, which all vertices are distinct, and except the starting and ending vertices, the closed vertices. So this is a cycle. Cycle is nothing but a closed path of length 3 or more. Length is 3 or more. What is the length? Length is nothing but number of edges. Now the length 3 or more means the edges are 3 or more edges and all vertices are distinct. The vertices are distinct except the starting and ending. That type of closed path is nothing but a cycle. A cycle of length k is called k cycle. This is the k cycle means length is k. Path and connectivity. So before going to this one, I will explain this path and paths and connectivity in the next video. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.